Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next question. So this question belongs to GATE CSC 2007, guys. Okay, so the given question is, consider the following two statements. Okay, so the two statements are, a hash function, these are often used for computing a digital signature, is an injective function. Okay, so what does option B say, sir? Okay, so I think, so this is a 1 and this is a 2, guys. Okay, so encryption technique such as DES performs a permutation on the elements of its input alphabets. Okay, so which of the following two is true? So basically, I think we did not discuss the exact flow of DES, but let's just go through the diagram once, guys. I'll be linking it in the description if I remember it, or you can watch it in my other channel. So basically, in my other channel, OU Education, you can find a clear video like exactly how it works. So basically, DES is working with the help of permutation and combinations, guys. So basically, it will take some inputs and it is going to make different combinations in different steps. So based on the input, so if it is 128 bit, it will do some steps. So if it is 64 bit, it will do some steps. So in that way, the count is also mentioned. So basically, these permutations are mandatory. So with that understanding, you can say that the second option is a true for sure. Okay, so with that, you can eliminate option one. Okay, you can eliminate this. You can keep a C and D. Okay, so what does option A says? Option A says that hashing, a hash function, they are often used to compute digital signatures, is injective function. So what exactly is injective function is a many to one, guys. Okay, anyway, we'll be discussing about these in discrete mathematics. Okay, so that will be the next subject. Okay, yes. So injective is nothing but many to one, right? But whenever we are doing hashing, we always want one to one mapping, right? Yes. So that is the main reason why option A could be wrong. So with that conclusion, you can say that C is the correct answer. Got it? Yes. So it's a type of theoretical question directly, right? Yes. So I hope everyone got a clear idea with respect to this question. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Okay, sorry for a silly confusion, guys. So basically, injective is a one to one, guys. But in hashing, every time we will not get one to one, right? So basically, hashing is sometimes work as many to one. So basically, if you assume, if you do hash mod 10, and if you had two inputs, 22 and 12. So at that time, if you are using linear probing, here you will get 22 and below it, you will get 12, right? Yes. So here indirectly, even though these two guys are mapped to the same value, so they are kept in different slots. So that is the reason why. So basically, injunction means one to one. Sorry for that silly confusion. But in some situations, hashing may occur to many to one. So with that conclusion, you can say that two is true and still one is false. Got it? Yes. And there are few algorithms which can do one to one also. Okay. Yes. So I hope everyone got a clear idea on this. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Like, share, and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.